We can analyze traffic using a product like Wireshark, which is a free open source application. So we can see here that I'm connected to my Ingenious access point. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up Wireshark. And when you install Wireshark, make sure you choose to install the WLAN option so that way it captures that wireless traffic. The reason you would want to capture and analyze wireless traffic is so you can determine the IP addresses your wireless is communicating with and on what ports. The troubleshooting reasoning for knowing this information is that you can determine if your wireless card is functioning properly and also to see why it may be running so slowly compared to other computers. Take a look, here is our Wi-Fi traffic. If I double click on it, now we can see it running. And it started automatically. I didn't even have to start it myself. But after a little while, what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to stop it so I can analyze it. And it's been running here for a little bit. So I've chosen the red stop button to stop the traffic from being monitored. And here we can see a lot of different traffic. Some's in blue, some is in pink. So let's see what some of this means. I am remoted in using a remote desktop into this computer that's running wireless, that's running Wireshark. So we can see the source IP address of 1.21 is communicating with my host computer, which is 1.111. And it's communicating on UDP 3389. It's also doing this on TCP 3389. So we see UDP traffic in blue, and we see TCP traffic, which is connection-oriented traffic, in pink. And there's nothing more important here than just letting you know it's two different types of traffic. When I highlight this UDP traffic, you can see it's coming in on port 3389, but then it's going out on port 53751. And that's because typically you would want to be able to have more than one computer be able to communicate, and you can't do it on the same port that another computer is communicating with. Now, in 3389 traffic, you can only have one computer connected at a time anyway, but the rule still stands. You always want to redirect it to a high-level port, say above 50,000, all the way up to 65,000, so that way you don't run into any other computers that try to communicate at that same port. I can also see it's running a lot of TLS traffic, and that stands for Transport Layer Security. And what's good about that is it means that our stream between my computer and the remote computer is being encrypted, because TLS is an encrypted service. It's an advanced form of SSL, or Secure Socket Layer. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a web browser and do some web browsing just to see how that changes our capture. So let's turn our capture back on again. And now it's capturing packets once again. I'll go back into the web browser and I'll just choose news. And it'll take us to this news site. Now I'm going to minimize. And we should see some new traffic besides just the 3389 traffic. I'll pause that. And here we can see the packet traffic going to this public address on TCP. And we can see the acknowledgement. And everything looks good. So how do we know if there's an actual problem with any of the traffic in Wireshark? Well, we can apply a filter. And in the filter box at the top, you just go ahead and type in severity equals error. And if it sees any of those, when you hit the enter key, then you're going to scroll through all the different errors. When I hit enter, I get nothing. And that's because I have no errors. So I just made sure that my wireless network traffic, my wireless network card, it does not have any problems. So if I'm having slowness, it's not because I'm having a problem with the card itself. However, if you see a lot of errors, it could be the network card. It could be the site that you're trying to communicate with. Maybe it's taking a bad path. Maybe there's a DNS issue, lots of different things. It doesn't necessarily mean it's the wireless network card itself. But if you do see errors, it's going to point you in the right direction to determine if this is a hardware problem or DNS or some other issue. Capturing wireless traffic and searching for errors can help you troubleshoot wireless problems quickly to determine the source of the problem.